Hey guys, welcome to this tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to seamlessly mix between two spine 2D animations in Unity by playing them simultaneously. I'll take this animated flower pot as an example, because I've used it as a checkpoint in my game project Fruits Against Vegetables. And what I'm going to do is make the flowers open once the player reaches the checkpoint. And the tricky part is keeping the smooth movement all the time, so that the player doesn't feel that there is any transition between the two animations. And by the way, you can use the same logics for your character animations as well. For example, making the player run and shoot at the same time. Alright, so let's get this implemented. Let's switch to spine and see what did I do there. I've got two animations for my flower pot, one for the movement cycle, and another one shows how each flower opens up. You can see that in the second animation, the flowers don't move. And this is because I'm going to merge between these two animations and I don't want any redundant movements. I've also created two skins for this rig, one with the closed flower buds and another one with the blossoming flowers. So basically, before the player reaches the checkpoint, I'm using one skin, and after the checkpoint is reached, I'm switching to another one. Cool! So that's all we need for this tutorial. Let's export the animations from Spine and import them into Unity. I'm going to do that really quickly now, but if you want to understand this process in details, you can watch our tutorial on how to export the animations from Spine and import into Unity. The link is in the description below. Alright, so here's our checkpoint skeleton imported into Unity. Let's click Create Animation Reference Assets button, and the new folder with the two reference files for our animations will appear. Awesome! Looks like they're working. Then, let's drag the skeleton data file to our scene, and between the three options that will pop up, you'll need to choose the first one, Skeleton Animation. Great! Let's change the sorting layer to the foreground, so that we can see it. Next, let's set the initial skin to checkpoint unchecked, because this is how the checkpoint looks before the player reaches it. Then, let's set the animation to idle, because this is the animation for the moving stems. And then, let's go ahead and see how it looks in the gameplay. Okay, the flowers are moving, but nothing happens when the player reaches the checkpoint. So let's fix that. Let's go to the scripts folder and create a new C# script, Checkpoint Controller. Drag it to your checkpoint object. And yes, let's rename the spine game object to checkpoint to make it clear. Awesome! Double-click the Checkpoint Controller script and it will open up in the editor. Okay, please make sure that you add a new namespace, using spine.unity, and that you have Spine Unity Runtime package installed. I put the link to the official package in the description below, just in case you don't have it, and you'll need to download and install it before proceeding to the next step of this tutorial. Alright, so let's add a couple of variables to our script. First, we'll need a public skeleton animation, and public animation reference asset checkpoint movement. This one will store the reference to the movement animation, and also checkpoint opening, that will store the reference to the second animation. Good! Now, in the start method, let's type skeleton animation equals get component skeleton animation. And if skeleton animation equals null, then the script should return. Alright, let's delete the update method as we don't need it here. Instead, we'll use private void onTriggerEnter2D that has a collider2D as a parameter. I'll rename the collision to other just because I like it that way. Great. Now, let's add an if block inside this method. If other.gameObject.compareTag player, then we'll call AddAnimation method. That will take checkpoint opening animation reference asset and boolean false. Of course, we don't have AddAnimation method yet, so let's create it. Public void AddAnimation. And let's set animation reference asset animation and bool loop as parameters. So basically, this new method should take a certain animation added on top of the animation that is already playing and play it in a loop or not, depends on how we want it to be. I've set the loop to false when calling this method because I want the flower buds to open just once. Okay, so inside this new method, let's type spine.trackEntryAnimationEntry equals skeletonAnimation.state.addAnimation. And this method takes four parameters: the track index, the animation name, whether it should be looped or not, and a delay. In our case, we'll type 1, animation, loop, and 0. So, it'll take the animation that we've passed to this method as a parameter, put it on animation track number 1, and play it just once without any delay. I know it might sound complicated, but it's going to be very easy once you see how it works. Now, why did I put the animation on track number 1? Because track number 0 already has the checkpoint movement animation, and I want these two animations to play simultaneously, so I put them on two different tracks. Okay, so let's go ahead and add one more line. AnimationEntry.complete plus equals AnimationEntry_complete. This line means that after the animation completes, the script needs to do something. And well, we'll need a new method for that. Under our last method, let's type private void AnimationEntry_complete. And it takes spine.trackEntry track entry as a parameter. Please use this exact syntax, because this is one of the standard Spine Unity runtime methods. And by the way, we're starting to have too many methods in this script, so I'll add a quick summary to each one of them. It is just a good practice. Awesome. Now, let's add the following to our last method. SkeletonAnimation.skeleton.setSkin checkpoint checked. So, after the player reaches the checkpoint, I want the flowers to stay open. This is why I switch to the second skin that I've created. And make sure that you type the exact name of the skin as you see it in Unity. Okay, let's save the script and go back to Unity. So, let's choose our animation assets from the list, and we still need to do a couple of things to make it work. Let's click Add Component, Box Collider 2D. And we need to check isTrigger checkbox, otherwise our onTriggerEnter2D method will not work. And the last thing, let's go to our player controller object and tag it as a player, because this is how our checkpoint knows that the player has reached it. Let's hit the play button and check how it works. Alright! Once the player reaches the checkpoint, the flowers are opening and they keep on moving. Then they stay open after that. But what happens if the player passes through once again? Oh, the flowers start to flicker. That's not what I want. Let's go back to the script to fix that. We'll need to add a new variable at the top of our script. Public bool is reached. Then, in onTriggerEnter2D method, let's make sure that the animation starts playing only if the player reaches the checkpoint for the first time. And then, under AddAnimationLine, let's type isReached equals true. That should fix it. Let's save the script and go back to Unity to see how it works now. Awesome! The movement is smooth and the flowers don't flicker anymore. That brings us to the end of this tutorial. Give it a thumbs up if you've learned something useful. And make sure you subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you next week.